Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see how to find an equilibrium point in an array. So let us first understand what is an equilibrium point. Let us say you are given an array of size 6 where the elements are 1, 2, 6, 4, 0 and minus 1. So what is an equilibrium point? An equilibrium point is defined as, if suppose we pick an element, let us say we pick this 6, then the sum of the elements on its left hand side and the sum of the elements on the right hand side are both equal. So let us say we pick this second index element and then find the left sum, then what will be the left sum array? The sum of the left array will be 1 plus 2, which will be 3. What will be the right sum array? The right sum array will be R sum is equals to 4 plus 0 plus minus 1, which will be equals to 3. So you can see that when we pick this second index element, then all the elements on the left hand side are equal to the all the elements on the right hand side. We are talking in terms of the summation only. Okay. So what can be the approach in order to find this equilibrium point? One such brute force approach, the first one is the brute force approach, can be that we will start iterating from this first element. Okay. This first index element, and then we will traverse the left array and find the left sum. We will traverse the right array and we will find the right sum, and then we will compare. If left sum equals to right sum, then we will return this index and we will say that this index is the equilibrium point. In this case, the first index is not the equilibrium point. So after checking, we will just move to the next element and then again repeat the same process. We find the left sum, we find the right sum by traversing the array, and then we compare if the left sum equals to the right sum. Okay, so in each iteration we are actually traversing the entire array order of n times. Okay, so we will be traversing order of n, that is the size of the array for each iteration, and there are n number of iterations. So time complexity will be n into n, which is equals to order of n square. So this is the brute force approach. We should always keep in mind the boundary conditions. Here some of the boundary conditions are also involved. So what are the boundary conditions? If we have just one element, then what will be the equilibrium index? The equilibrium index will always be that element which is present if the array is having just one element. Okay, and if the array is having two elements, then what will be the equilibrium index? There will be no equilibrium index in any case. Let us say you are having an array having two elements, 1 and 2. Okay, then we cannot fix one index and say that the left sum equals to right sum, even if there is a 0. Because if we have just two elements, then you can either have the left array or you can have the right array. In this case, you are having the left array, and if we take this case and we fix this 2, then you are just having the right array and you don't have any left array. Okay, so when you have two elements, then there will be no equilibrium point in any case. So you first check for these boundary conditions. If you have just one element, then return that element as a equilibrium point. That element will always be the equilibrium point, because let us say you have element 1, then there is no element to the left hand side as well as there is no element to the right hand side. Therefore you can say that this is the equilibrium point. But when you have two elements, then there will be no equilibrium point possible in any case. This algorithm is only for elements which are 3 or greater than 3. That means you have the number of elements in the array greater than equals to 3. So let us look at a better approach in order to solve this problem. So our array was 1, 2, 6, 4, 0, minus 1. So how can we improve the time complexity? We need to do certain pre-processing. What will be the pre-processing step? The pre-processing will involve that we will find the sum at each point. Okay, we will keep finding the sum and we will move from left to right. So at index 0, what will be the sum value? Sum value will be 1. At index 1, what will be the sum value? It will be 1 plus 2, which will be 3. At index 2, what will be the sum value? It will be 6 plus 3, which will be 9. At index 3, what will be the sum value? It will be 4 plus 9, which will be equals to 13. Similarly, at index 4, you have 13, and at index 5, you have 13 plus minus 1, which will be 12. Okay. So, the total value, the entire sum of this array is equals to 12. Okay. And this is the left sum array. That means at any index, if you pick say index 3, then you can say that the sum of the elements from the start index to this index 3 is equals to 13. So this is, let us say this is the sum array and this is our array ARR. Okay. So how can we find whether this is having any equilibrium point or not? And if that is present, then where it is present? One such algorithm is, we will start iterating from this first index. Of course, this is done after checking for the boundary conditions, that is whether the array is having one element or two element. If the array is having more than two elements, then we will follow this algorithm. We will start iterating from the first index. Okay, and we will iterate till the second last index. So we will start our loop I equals to 1 to I less than n minus 1. Okay. So this will be the iteration because n minus 1 is this value 4. Okay. We will iterate for all the elements and we will check if left sum equals to right sum. If left sum equals to right sum, then we will return the index I. Okay. So this is our entire algorithm. Now, the main problem is to find the left sum and right sum. In our previous approach, the brute force method, for finding the left sum and right sum, we took order of n time and therefore our time complexity was order of n square. But here we have pre-processed and kept the entire left sum. Okay. So when we are at index 1, now how can we find the left sum? The left sum will be equals to sum at index I minus array at index I. This will be equals to the left sum. Okay, so let us say you are at index 1. Now how can you find the left sum? Sum at I, which is equals to this element 3, and that will be subtracted with the current index element, which is 2. Therefore, you can say that the left sum at index 1 is equals to 1. What will be the right sum? You can always find the right sum by subtracting the total value from this sum value. Okay. So what will be the formula for right sum? Right sum will be equals to the total value, that means the total sum of the entire elements present in the array, and that will be subtracted with sum at I. Why? Because the total is indicating the entire sum and we need the sum of only this part. Okay. In this case, when we are fixing index 1, then we need the sum of this part only. Okay. And that will be equals to the entire sum of the array, and this part will be subtracted from it. Okay. And this part is nothing but this will be sum at 1. Because sum at 1 is 1 plus 2, which is equals to 3. And this entire sum is nothing but total. So when we subtract sum 1 from this total part, then we get this part. Okay. So this is how we are calculating the right sum. And these two just take order of 1 time. Okay. So we can compare that 1 is 1 equals to 12 minus 3, which will be 9. Is 1 equals to 9? No, this is not equal. So we will increment our I pointer and it will move to this second index. Okay. Now we again find the left sum. The left sum is found by using the formula sum at I, which is 9, minus the current index element, that is 9 minus 6, which is equals to 3. So left sum will be now 3. What will be the right sum? It will be total minus sum at 2, which will be equals to 12 minus 9. It will be equals to 3. Okay. So now you can see that left sum equals to right sum. Therefore, we will return the index 2 as result. And you can manually check that the right sum is 4 plus 0 plus minus 1, which is 3. And the left sum is 1 plus 2, which is 3. So this will definitely work. Okay. And the time complexity for this is just order of n. We are pre-processing this array and we are taking an extra space of order of n. This is the extra space. But by using this order of n extra space, we are heavily decreasing the time complexity, and this is solved in just order of n time. Okay, order of n time for solving and order of n time for pre-processing, therefore order of 2n time, which is nothing but order of n time. I hope you are able to understand how to find equilibrium point in an array. If you have any type of doubt, then please comment below and I will help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.